This is a GCS News Break.
Every school, if they choose, has their own school-based science fair at their level. And then the top winners then advance to our district science fair at the Greensboro Science Center. So those top level winners, everything from elementary through secondary, come to compete against other schools to see who now gets to advance to our regional level, which will be held in February. But the cool thing about having it here at the Greensboro Science Center is not only do they get to, you know, present their projects and see other people's projects, but the Science Center opens up all day for those students. So while they're not presenting, they're getting to go around and see all the exhibits. They have different stations set up for them to interact with cool hands-on science and STEM activities. So it's really just a full day of learning and exploring and also presenting their science fair projects. With the judging process, what happens is the students are at their boards and they talk about their projects. The judges are asking them questions, you know, about, you know, where did they come up with the idea? You know, what was their experiment process? You know, what did they conclude from it? And one of the big things that we always talk to them about is what are those next steps? Because as a STEM department, we want our kids to really think about when they're doing these science fair projects is not just what did they find in this moment, but how can they now take what they found and expand on it? Because we want science and learning to continue to happen even past that science fair project. These are things that students truly have an interest in and they wanted to take the time to explore and learn more about. So to me, that is the most interesting piece is walking around and talking with a third grader who is excited about what they're studying, looking at students who have built like everything from like catapults to, you know, looking at how different things grow. This could be that catalyst to help them get more passionate about STEM and science and lead to a future career.
So I was curious about the many ways of making meringue. So my project was basically testing, does the egg temperature matter when you're creating meringue? And which acid causes the meringue to firm up the most? Basically, meringue is just egg whites mixed with sugar. A lot of bakers add acid to it. So what I found is that when you add acid to it, it creates a more creamy and stable meringue. And then in between the two acids that I used, lemon juice and vinegar, which I wanted to make sure they were households, there wasn't much of a difference. But I did bake them to see if that could give a difference. And I found that vinegar samples were a little bit more creamier. When you're using room temperature eggs, if you know that you're good at baking and you're good with time management, those might be better for you. If you want to have room for mistakes and you just want to, you know, have fun with it, I would use cold eggs. Without science, you can't have other things. You don't understand really what everything is. Like, why is the world round? Or why does food taste the way food tastes? So I think without science, you really would have so many unanswered questions. Science really does change the world because you get to learn so many new things that without science you wouldn't be able to.
For me, that is one of the coolest things is that every child has that spark of curiosity and, you know, just imagination piece in them. And they are using that to catalyze into something that they love doing and creating projects around it.
This has been a GCS News Break.